Hi everybody, welcome to NuttX channel. Today I will explain how to use an ultraviolet sensor, Vishay VEML6070, this one. Let's see. Okay, in the NuttX. So let's get started. Open the Linux terminal. Enter inside NuttX space, NuttX, execute, make this clean to clear previous configuration. Now we need to check if our board has support to ultraviolet sensor. LS configs STM32F103 minimum SRC. STM32_VEML6070.C. Okay, our board has support to sensor. Now we can execute the configure tools config.sa STM32F103 minimum /NSH. Execute make menu config to enable the UV sensor. Make menu config. First, we need to select the options to enable the USB console. If you don't know how to do that, please watch this video explain. Okay, the USB console was enabled. Now I will show how to enable the UV sensor. Enter inside system type, STM32 peripheral support, and enable I2C1 or I2C1. Exit, exit again. Enter inside device drivers. Go to sensors, device support, and enable Vishay VEM6070. Exit, exit again. Enter inside application configuration, example, and enable the VEML6070 ultraviolet sensor example. Exit, exit again, and finally exit and save. Execute make to compile the source code. Okay, the source code was compiled correctly. Now we can flash the firmware inside the board. If you don't know how to do that, please watch this video explain. Ctrl R. Open OCD, Ctrl L to move up, and press Enter. Okay, the firmware was flashed. I will show now how to connect the sensor module in the board. So let's get started. First, connect the VCC to 3.3 volts here, then connect the ground or GND to G-pin. Okay. Then connect the I2C clock or SCL to B6 and then connect the I2C data or SDA to B7. Okay, basically that is it. Now we can connect the USB cable. I connect the sensor in the board. Now let's see if the USB console was detected. The mask. Okay, it was detected. Now we can run minicon and change to ACM0. Press enter 3 times. 1, 2, 3. Let's see if the device driver was created. ls/dev. Okay, it was created. Let's see if the application is here. Okay, the sensor application is also here. Now we can run it. Okay, it's working and show a low value. If I put the sensor in the sunlight, it will increase. So let's test it now. Directly in the sun, I can see 400 and above, so it is working fine. Basically, that is it. I hope you had enjoyed this video. And see you in the next video. Bye bye.